Hello, we are the middle school vocal majors from Idaho Fine Arts Academy. Our teacher is Leigh Falconer. Our first song today is Vuelve by Froda Fjellheim and Christopher Beck. It is inspired by the tradition Sami Yoik. Yoik is a very old vocal tradition among the Sami people of Scandinavia and Russia. The Samis say that the Yoik has no beginning and no end. Our next song, Sea Lullaby by Eric Whitaker, is set. Our next song, Sea Lullaby by Eric Whitaker, is set to the lyrics by the author Rudyard Kipling, who is the author of The Jungle Book. It tells a tale of a mother seal singing softly to her young cub. Our accompanist is Katie Hughes. Thank you.
song, Jubula Jason, is based on an African folk song arranged by seven hatfields. You can hear throughout the use of repeated patterns called ostinatos and interesting polyrhythms, which create interesting textures and make it a fun piece to sing. Our soloist is Lexi Ritchie. Thank you.
Always, always be nice to the accompanist. I just want to tell you, the thing that I was most struck by was the way that you changed your tone between songs, which is so cool. And I see that look. Have you worked on that? Yeah, a little bit. Because your yoik had a whole different vocal tone than your seal's lullaby. And I'm hoping it was intentional. If not, then it was brilliant. I'm still brilliant, but very nice. Few choirs your age actually can do that. And I think that was just super cool. Also, another thing, one of the things that I listen for when I'm thinking, is this a good choir? Is the quality of your ooh sound. And in the lullaby, you have beautiful oohs. I mean, just super beautiful oohs. And those are hard to sing for long periods of time, to keep that energy focused all the way through that. And so I'm gonna just talk a little bit about your energy. You've got overall really great energy, but every once in a while, because it is so good, and right now, the things I'm gonna say to you are super picky, because, I mean, you're already really good. And remember this, all you choirs, that when your teacher starts getting super picky, don't roll your eyes and go, oh man, that means that you're doing awesome. The more, the better you're doing, the pickier we as teachers can be, because that way we're getting into the true artistry of the music. So if they're like just picking on little teeny tiny things, that's an awesome compliment, because you've already taken care of all the big things. So I'm just gonna be super picky today. Can we start just a little bit on the Jabula Jesu? Cool song. All your music is super cool today. When you first started out, you had this burst of energy, and I saw faces, and you're like, oh yeah, we get to sing this song. Then you got kind of middle way, and it drooped just slightly. I mean, like I said, I'm just for being picky. So what we need to do as musicians, and as singers especially, is know how to kind of pace yourself. And it's just like breathing. Whenever you have a long phrase, you don't want to get rid of all your breath at the beginning of the phrase, because you want to make sure you know where you're going. So I tell my singers always to have kind of a movie playing in their mind about what the song is about. And it can be individual for each one of you guys, but raise your hand, tell me, what is this song for you? What does this song mean? Yes. So it's kind of a party song? Yeah, party song, okay.
I believe it's a song about honoring someone who is great, who had just died, for example, like a chief. So they're honoring the life, since they say no, just
love. Yeah, so an honor, a celebration of life for someone that's passed. Okay, awesome.
My thought was like, is that a festival with bright colors everywhere?
I love that. And all those three things are not mutually exclusive. I mean, that kind of combines. So what's really cool about what we do as singers is, and I spoke to this earlier today, is we are storytellers. That's what makes it different between us and instrumental players. I'm a pianist, and I believe that we as pianists can tell stories. But as singers, we have words, even if they're kind of nonsense words, like in the yoik, in the first one, I'm not even gonna try to pronounce it, because, yeah, you guys did a good job on that. But maybe they weren't nonsense words, but a lot of times we do sing syllables that don't really necessarily have meaning in that traditional sense, but then we impart the meaning to that. And so for Jabula Jesu, I want you to have in mind a really specific celebration. And then what we do is we put all of those celebrations together, and that's when we get that really cool finished product. Okay, can you start Jabula Jesu for me? Is so great. Your consonants, your vowels are so cool. Now I want to see all of that reflected more physically. You guys are doing a really nice job. I mean, your focus is awesome, but I want to sing. I mean, I've had the great good fortune about 10 years ago of going to Africa, and this is a people who sing all the time, and I would guess, unless there's a specific instance, that you're never gonna see someone from Africa standing still, ever, when they sing. Not even ever, a little bit. And we also forget sometimes when we do songs from different cultures that these are actually really songs from a different culture. Sometimes we think that's just, you know, something that we're singing. But no, indeed, these are songs from somewhere else in the world that actual people sing. And so I want, and we're just gonna exaggerate, we're just gonna kind of be silly for a second. Yeah, that's.
Can I come down onto the floor also?
Yes. Excellent. Yeah, no, that was awesome. And you know what? We could, in performance, you can do that. Yeah, will that disturb anybody out there if they dance a little bit? No, go back on your risers and put a little bit of what you just did into while you're on the road. And when you do those little slides, you know, feel free to like, yeah, wake up in the morning. Yeah, it's okay. Yes, I am. Yeah, that is so cool. And what that also does is that energizes your tone in a way that we can't just get from good breath support and all that sort of stuff. It makes it sparkle. And you guys are sparkly, which is so cool, and that's really wonderful. When I go to the American Choral Directors Association conferences, and I've gone to all kinds of them all over the place, the choirs that are the most favorite of everybody are the ones that dance, that move and participate. That's what they love. And I talked about this earlier too, that we as choral directors, we work so hard on getting you to stand still and, you know, with good singing position. But then we ask you then to break it. And so that's the challenge, is to know when you're gonna stand still, like for Sing a Lullaby, because that's the story you're gonna be telling with your face and your beautiful phrases. But then this is waking up in the moonlight and we're singing. And that's what we as an audience really want to hear. So that is so cool.
How much time do I have?
I'm done. Thank you for a fabulous performance. And Mrs. Falconer, you got to give her a round. She's off.